Hi, this is Matthias here from Windsor.ai, and today I'll show you how you get Google Search Console data connected to Power BI. Before you start, please make sure that you have access to Google Search Console, and please make sure that you have Power BI Desktop installed. Let's get started. First of all, you go to onboard.windsor.ai, and once you're on there, you look for Search Console. Click on Google Search Console. Then you click on Grant Search Console Access, and then you'll be prompted to grant access to your Search Console account. Once this is done, you'll be able to select your Search Console accounts. In case you have many of them, you can add all of them or only one of them. For this demo, I'm adding one Search Console account. Then once you're done, you click on Preview and Destination on top, and then you select your data source. You will only have Search Console here. I have many other sources here. So I'm clicking Search Console, and then I click Get Data. Now you see the account name, which is the property name in Search Console, and then you see the clicks and the date. So now you can start to add the metrics and dimensions you would like to add. So let's say I would like that on a page granularity. And then we have page added, and this data set starts to get quite big. So I'm not going to add more metrics here, but of course you could add country or whatever other metrics and dimensions you would like here. But for this example, I'm just going to bring property name, click state, and page over. And don't forget to include date. Otherwise, it will be hard to make time series and filter by date in Power BI Desktop. Once this is done, you click on Power BI Desktop, and then you will see the copy button here. You copy that, and then you open Power BI. Within Power BI, you click on Get Data from Web, and then you paste the URL in, and then the data will be loading. Let me click OK. And then the data is here. Now you can do a quick QA. You see the property name, click state, page, click close and apply, and then the data is available for you to build a report with. You see now with only a few days data and page dimension, I'm already getting 7,000 rows. So in case you don't have a powerful laptop, you might want to query shorter date ranges. It gets quite resource intensive quick with Power BI. So now I can create a chart here. I add the page and sum of clicks. And now you can start working with the data. That's it. Now you have your Search Console data in Power BI. Now what you would do is, in case you have multiple reports, you repeat that process. So let's say I would want to add a second report on a country dimension. You would add country name and then click Get Data, and then you make a second export. We also do offer a template in case you want to get started with the visual template straight away. I'll add the link below so you can get started with that. Thanks very much for watching, and have fun using our connectors.